Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So let's get on to covering the multiple choice questions for prelims 2020 and question number 1. The stage at which an industry prefers to run in its former or original location despite the disappearance of initial advantages is known as what? Number 1, industrial melanism. Second is industrial fatigue. Third is industrial inertia, and the last is industrial agglomeration. So herein, even if you have no idea what the right answer is, still do try to understand the statement and try to come up with the right answer, because answer lies in the meaning of these words only. So what is melanism, what is fatigue, what is inertia, and what is agglomeration? I'm sure we all know their meaning, so that's how answer can be arrived upon. So either way, we are to look at the right answer here. So herein, answer is C, that is industrial inertia. We know in physics there is a term called inertia, wherein a body prefers to be in its original position. It doesn't tend to change unless an external force is applied. So herein, whenever an industry prefers to run in its original location, even though the initial advantages have long overgone, still the industry is keeping there itself, so that would be industrial inertia. So we are to understand all these statements, let's not deviate too much. So let's get on to the details here. Number 1, what is industrial inertia? A stage at which an industry prefers to run in its former location, although the main alluring or attracting factors are gone. Now, how and why it would be happening? Let's not go into those details. It could be many reasons. Maybe because it's really difficult to transport your setup, that capital investment that one entrepreneur has undertaken. It's not that easy to shift that very thing again to a new location, right? So those could be the reason, or maybe person is attached to that very area. There could be many reasons for that, but that are not important. All we have to understand is what is industrial inertia, and that's it. Now, what is industrial fatigue? Fatigue as in tiredness. Tiredness of what? Of any activity that one is doing in the industry. So mental or physical exhaustion resulting from performing required work related activities that lead to diminished or decreasing capacity for performing the work. It is generally attributed to poor working conditions or demanding job requirements. So it's quite self-explanatory and it's easy as well. And what is industrial agglomeration? So agglomeration simply means a group, a cluster. So basically, when industries or the firms, industry itself means a group of firms. So firms, when they are coming together in one area, that is industrial agglomeration. And why would they be clustering in one area? Because of certain advantages. For example, infrastructure can be better developed. Skilled labor of that particular industry is attracted to the area. It encourages more investment in that area. And these factors can cut production cost and increases productivity. So this is either way obvious. Herein we are talking about the advantages of the industrial agglomeration. So this is the advantages that these industries or firms would be providing to other people. But why would they be attracted to form the agglomeration? Because they are having some sort of benefits in terms of maybe economies of scale. Agar do char firms aake ek jagah production karengi, to unko raw material concession milega. Maybe they be needing only one power plant for the electricity generation, or maybe they would be getting some tax concessions from the government. So all these are the benefits of forming an industrial agglomeration. So let's get on to the last point, that is industrial melanism. Now, what is melanism? In yesterday's not in the this very session of a previous year multiple choice question, but in Species in News we discussed about the melanism. So herein, melanism is just a chemical that gives a dark color to the animals or to any living entity. So what is industrial melanism? Basically, just because the animals are residing right there in the vicinity of the industrial area. So as a natural selection, they have the dark colored pigmentation. So just because it's easy to hide themselves in the industrial area if your color is darker, at least it's been written over here. And how and why, I do not know, and we don't supposed to really be knowing this thing. So industrial melanism is what? So basically a prevalence of dark colored varieties of animals in industrial area where they are better camouflaged than paler forms. So it is a process of natural selection. So that's it. It's quite self-explanatory, and 5 minutes are gone. We've just solved one question. So let's not deviate too much and let's get on to question number two. Which of the following is are correct regarding the Budapest Convention? All right. What is it? Number one, it's an international agreement that seeks to address internet and computer crime. Second, it's an initiative led by United States of America. Last is India has not yet adopted the convention. Very, very simple question, and unfortunately have shown the answer as well. But either way, we are supposed to know the details of this convention. So answer here is that yes, statement number one is correct. Statement number two is not correct, and three is also correct. So that's how answer is C. But let's get on to the details of this convention now. Number one, and the most important point is, it is by the Council of Europe's. Name is the Council of Europe's Cybercrime Convention, also known as the Budapest Convention. When did it come into force? 2001. It is related to what? To address the internet and computer crime. Is it binding? Yes, it's the only international binding instrument that addresses internet and computer crime. Protocol on Xenophobia and Racism is also supplementing this convention. And what is Councils of Europe? Basically, it's a body that comprises of 49 nations that came into being in 1947 somewhere. So do Google a bit about the Councils of Europe. So it has nothing to do with the United States of America. Although USA too is a member, it has 56 members including United States of America and UK, but it's been spearheaded by the Council of Europe. And India is not its member, very, very important. Why India is not a member? Because of sovereignty issue. India argued that it was not a party to its formation. India did not participate in its drafting. So sovereignty issues are there, so we are not its member. This is the most important point. So we are done with this. Let's get on to the next question now. This is the last second. Consider the following statements about the Consumer Expenditure Survey. What are these? Number one, it is carried out by the Reserve Bank of India. All right. Second is, it provides information regarding expenditure on goods and services consumed by household in the food category only. All right. So what is the right answer? One only, two only, both or none? So do try to come up with the right answer here as well. So basically, none of these statements are correct. And here lies the explanation. Who is carrying this survey? Very, very important. The National Statistical Office. And this office is under MoSPI, that is Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. So RBI has nothing to do with the Consumer Expenditure Survey. And second, it is carried out every 5 years, that is quinquennial. And the third important point is this, that it collects information about expenditure on consumption of goods and services. And goods and services includes food as well as non-food items. Consumed by who? Consumed by household. So it's not the individual, it's household. The question may household ki jagah individual bhi likh sakte hain, so we need to be very careful. It's both food as well as non-food. And why we are studying this thing right now? Because government of India decided that there were certain issues with the data collected as per this consumer expenditure survey of 2017-18, so government decided not to release its data, and once more the survey would be conducted. And that's it. The context is not important, but details are. So consumer expenditure survey by MOSPI, by NSO, by consumption by households, both food as well as non-food, every 5-year quinquennial interval. So let's get on to the last question now, which is really, really simple. Project Starlink, sometimes seen in news, is related to what? Number one, imaging of a black hole. Alright. Second is communication satellites in space. C is solar power production technology. And the last is sun exploration mission. So this is really simple. Project Starlink is what? It is basically the communication satellites in space. So SpaceX, the American company, it has decided to launch constellation number of satellites, and we would be calling it Starlink, and as it is a satellite, it would be providing the internet access to the inaccessible areas. So this is it, number of satellites and all the details are not important because that keeps changing. All we have to keep a tab on is just one point. Project Starlink is regarding the launch of satellites to provide satellite internet access, and it is by the SpaceX, not by any NASA or any such agency, but by the American private company SpaceX, and that's it. So we are done with the questions for day 32nd. If you have gotten any doubt, then do let me know in the comment section. We'll go through that question once again. And thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.